안녕하세요. 복선 재테크의 피치데드입니다. 이렇게 장이 변동성이 심할 때는 투자 대가들의 시장 전망에 대해서 들어보면서 멘탈 관리를 하는 게 좋은 방법이라고 생각합니다. 금요일 밤 주식시장 때문에 잠 못 이루는 모든 사람들에게 이 영상을 공유합니다. 화이팅입니다.
The recent spread of the new coronavirus feels like it's hit almost everywhere. It's shaken global financial markets, but it's also affected human lives and our communities. With such quick and unprecedented changes hitting so close to home, it's easy to understand why people are nervous. This nervousness can sometimes lead us to make financial decisions that work against our goals. At Fisher Investments, our experience has shown that in volatile, scary times, what's most important to helping protect your financial future is being patient, disciplined, and focused on the long term. In this video, we'll help you understand how markets react to these types of events. And we'll give you some reasons to stay positive and calm in the face of chaotic markets. Some of the key points we'll cover. First, this downturn has been quick. In mid-February, the stock market was hitting all-time highs. Then, coronavirus began to spread more quickly across several countries. Markets began reacting not to the toll of the virus, but to the unprecedented response from governments and companies requiring full or partial shutdowns in an effort to contain the virus that has slowed the economic activity. That response has been drastically different than previous outbreaks. If you read the news or watch TV, you've probably heard talk about the size of the market drop or the economic impact of the shutdowns and closures. However, we believe the duration of the economic impact is more important than the magnitude at this point. For example, if the virus recedes with the end of the typical flu season in the Northern Hemisphere and the shutdowns come to an end, stocks could bounce back more quickly than many people anticipate. An important market truism is that stocks typically move ahead of the economy. Given how big the stock market decline has been, even if a recession sets in, stocks have probably already priced that possibility in. Lastly, watch for the V. Because when the stock market drops quickly, there's often a recovery that's just as quick. This creates a sharp turning point in the market and shows up as a V pattern in the path of stocks. Investors should be ready for that turning point and the positive side of the V. The stock market can be counterintuitive, to say the least. While these are certainly scary times, we actually see reason to be optimistic. Warren Buffett, one of the world's most successful investors, had this to say about market turning points. Be fearful when others are greedy, and greedy when others are fearful. What he meant is that following the crowd, especially when it comes to investing, isn't always the smartest strategy. When everyone seems to think that nothing could possibly go wrong, Buffett recommends caution. He's worried that in that type of environment, markets are flush with euphoria and ignoring potential pitfalls. And when it appears everyone is saying things are at their worst, Buffett sees potential and an opportunity to make smart investments where others have overreacted. We believe this approach applies today. With all the market volatility and negative news, you might be thinking it's best to pull your money out of the market and wait until things get calmer. But one of the biggest investing mistakes you can make is missing out on the start of a new bull market. Why? Because trying to time a market downturn by pulling your money out and putting it back in at just the right time requires a lot of luck. And we don't know of anyone, including investing professionals, who is consistently that lucky. Second, market recoveries tend to start with a bang. This graph shows how the S&P 500 reacted after the end of the 2008 global financial crisis. That V at the bottom of the graph is typical of the market turning point. The sharpest part of the big market decline typically happens just when it's almost over. And then, stocks tend to take off like a rocket, mirroring the speed and magnitude of the end of the downturn. Waiting too long to get back into the market and missing that initial stage of the upswing can be costly. How costly? Well, look at this table of modern bull market returns. You'll see the first few months of a new bull market tend to be supercharged. Looking at U.S. stocks, the average return during the first month of a new bull market was 11%. 3 months was just over 22%. And in the first 12 months, the market averaged over 47%. That's a lot of positive return you'd miss if you're waiting on the sidelines. And those returns go a long way to help your portfolio recover from the bear market. Taking a longer-term view, You can see a do-nothing strategy during volatile times is often completely fine. Why? Every bear market is followed by a bull market, and bull markets tend to be much more powerful than bears. That means making sure you don't miss out on bull market returns is much more important than avoiding bear market declines. There have been 11 bear markets since 1946, marked by red boxes on this graph. That means there have also been 11 bull markets too, marked in green. The width of each box shows how long each bull or bear market lasted, and the height shows how big each was. You'll notice a lot more green than red on this graph. That's because bull markets tend to be longer and stronger than the typical bear market. On average, bear markets lasted 16 months and declined about 34% from high to low. The average bull markets, on the other hand, lasted almost 5 years and returned around 149%. That's an important reason to stay optimistic. While negative returns hurt and volatility can be scary, over the long term, positive bull market returns tend to overwhelm those bear market periods. What's next for markets is uncertain, but we at Fisher Investments are watching for three potential scenarios. Worst case would be if the current shutdowns and closures go on indefinitely, as shown in scenario A. While we don't think this is likely, a deep global recession could be possible in this situation. Such unprecedented global economic interruption would make it very difficult to see a new bull market starting soon. However, if the shutdowns and closures last about 3 months or longer, but not indefinitely, we believe a global recession still seems likely, but not as catastrophic. This would be scenario B. There'd still be volatility, but markets would likely move lower quickly to adjust to the news. In scenario C, which we currently think is the most likely, shutdowns last for less than 3 months. In that case, economic activity likely picks back up relatively quickly, and the world either avoids a recession or only sees a small one. Expect short-term volatility, but stock prices should trend higher over the following 6 to 18 months. It's impossible to say with certainty which scenario will happen, but we find it promising to look at a country like China, which was the first affected by the virus, which has contained the spread, and within a couple of months has seen a significant relative rebound from an economic and market perspective. Regardless of how this plays out, remember the important part is staying calm and collected. The next bull market will come, if it hasn't already, and you don't want to miss out on those returns for your long-term.